You've probably heard of OLTP and OLAP type of workloads, but what actually happens in the real world and how does Azure SQL and SQL Server help? Learn more in this episode of Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined once again by Silvano, a program manager on the Azure Data team. Thanks for joining us today.
Oh, thanks a lot for having me, Anna.
Always a pleasure. And today, we're going to be talking about HTAP, which might be new to some of you, might be familiar to some of you, and kind of how it relates to Azure SQL. But before we get into that, Silvano, I was wondering if you could kind of walk us through like what the different type of workloads we see people using are.
Yeah, absolutely. So traditionally speaking, we've been discussing about some of the common type of workloads in relational database in general. We are very well aware of the online transactional processing or OLTP, where our data model is actually highly normalized in order to kind of optimize our data design for concurrency, for kind of data modification operations, insertions and updates and so on. And we have a kind of very selective queries typically that are supported by indexes for basically fast retrieval, so to speed up applications. Right. And we are actually enforcing the kind of consistency through some sort of constraints, domain, referential integrity, and such, right? On the other hand, we typically refer to online analytical processing, where we are going to support typically kind of reporting and analytical processing on very denormalized data models, where we are actually duplicating typically data in order to optimize for, again, retrieve a lot of data, operate aggregations, and typically we are running queries that are doing large scans behind the scenes or ranges and aggregations and such. So those are the pretty kind of canonical database workloads that everybody knows in theory. But the reality is that in a lot of applications are actually generating kind of mixed workloads, right? Where, yes, you have a lot of kind of OLTP type of interactions with the database, but at the same time, there are also some kind of analytical queries that are hitting our database while this is actually processing transactional workloads, right? So in most cases in real life, our workloads belongs to this particular category. And there are techniques usually in order to trade off between these two extremes of OLTP and OLAP in order to get a good performance. But what we're going to talk about today is how SQL Server first and Azure SQL database now is going to provide specific support for running efficiently this kind of hybrid and mixed workloads on top of the same exact kind of database structure.
Awesome. This was a great overview, Silvano. So what I'm understanding is we have OLTP and we have OLAP, but more commonly we're seeing a mix of that, and that's where this HTAP comes in. So I'd love to hear more how SQL Server enables these HTAP type of workloads.
Yeah, HTAP, this is interesting. HTAP is a term that Gartner actually introduced a few years ago. And it was talking about this hybrid transaction analytical processing as one of the key kind of the main drivers for the future in relational database. And SQL Server, starting from 2016, is actually introducing a bunch of specific capabilities to help driving those H-type workloads, so those hybrid workloads, by basically mastering in-memory type of processing in traditional kind of relational databases. So if we are talking about how SQL Server and Azure SQL is enabling this kind of real-time operational analytics, we have to talk about some technologies like, for example, our columnar indexes that we can build on top of disk-based OLTP tables, so traditional tables that are persisted on disks, but also the ability to actually create the same columnar indexes on top of in-memory tables, right? By combining these two, we can run these kind of advanced and hybrid workloads on the same data structure and make, you know, our OLTP faster through this kind of in-memory data access, but at the same time also analytical queries that are going to benefit by this columnar data structure and indexes that are speeding up aggregations and analytical workloads, right? So by bringing the two together, we can, for example, eliminate in some cases the need for transforming, for running ETL processes on top of our OLTP data in order to kind of denormalize them and create traditional data warehouses, right? So in some cases, when we need this kind of fast and real-time type of analytics, we can effectively speed up our performance by orders of magnitude. Actually, in memory OLTP tables right now, we can run 30x faster, actually. And for analytical queries, we have benchmark results where we can get 100x kind of faster for analytical queries.
Wow, that's awesome. And you know, you've kind of talked to us about like what this is and how SQL Server Azure SQL enables it. And I think this has been a great overview. I'm sure there are some things to think about, especially when we look at Azure SQL, you know, like what service tier is this available in? How do I set this up? We are going to do a few more videos. What are some of the, you know, can you give us a sneak peek on what you're going to show us in the following videos on how we're going to dive deeper?
Absolutely. And by the way, memory is expensive, right? So we know that in Azure SQL, we have a bunch of service tiers with different characteristics, depending on the kind of level of service that those service tiers are offering. For the in-memory OLTP tables, we have to pick up our top kind of service tier. So we're talking about business critical or premium for the DTU based model. So in order to be able to run this particular kind of in-memory feature, those are the service tiers that we need. So it's important that we pick up the right service tier in case we need this very fast OLTP structure. While on the other hand, column store indexes are actually based on pretty much all our service tiers, starting from S2, so from the standard service tier two up to all the other service tiers available, including hyperscale. Right, so it's important. You know, we have documented all these different flavors, and in our kind of next videos, we are going to drill down a little bit into these details.
Awesome, thanks, Ivano, and thanks for this overview. It was a great overview. I'm really interested to learn more about HTAP and how we can kind of get the most out of it when it comes to our Azure SQL workloads, especially since we know so commonly these are these mixed type of workloads. So thanks for being on the show. For our viewers, we'll put some links in the description to learn more, and we hope you join us next time when we dive deeper into this topic. Thanks for joining us on Data Exposed.